I am the angry gay Pope, oddball Emmy-winning Scientology protester, and I'm using my inside voice. Yes, I am a gay theist, but I'm not the only gay Scientology whistleblower. There is also deceased ex-Scientologist Happy Smurf, my lawyer Graham Berry, and my felonious protege Nasty Nathaniel. Hollywood cult protesting now has a new gay fruit in the loop, hairdresser Steven Mango. But I don't think he rises to their level of success. Aspiring actor Steven Mango joined the Church of Scientology without reading their internet reviews.
They say it brainwashes people.
Do I look like I'm brainwashed to you?
Mango rides the critic train, making self-important couch videos about how he left said religion.
Or over on Mangotology, where I take you inside the world of the Church of Scientology. This work that I do on YouTube isn't just like fun and games, making videos. This is real serious stuff, guys. This is stuff that affects not only my life, but my husband's life, my dogs, my family, my friends. Like,
he makes YouTube couch videos about other YouTube couch video makers.
You guys might recognize me from my other two channels, Mango Tea, or I Spill the Tea on Beauty Drama and Beauty Influencers, because I want to be one of the best drama channels on YouTube.
I'll save you a lot of time, because from what I've seen from the Mango videos I've watched, there's always going to be a big chunk where he's going to talk about his experiences with all of the jobs he's not doing.
It's hilarious that you call us fake and then refer to yourself as being so real, because you call me out, you call everyone else out, but you have all of us blocked, so we can't see shit. So it's like, if you're gonna talk shit, at least tag us and give us the opportunity to respond back to you and defend ourselves. So this normally happens when he's low on content ideas and he needs attention on his channel.
He makes cooking videos.
So stay tuned to watch how I make this, and maybe you millennials will learn some life skills.
Hey guys, and welcome to my new channel.
He plans to market makeup.
Excited.
He is married to a gay lawyer. You was at the club, bottoms up, when I first met you, couldn't get the... He overshares.
Craziness that I was kind of experiencing. So when he gave me this diagnosis of what this condition I'm about to reveal is, he's like, you know what, don't tell anyone. And that's why I never ever talked about it. Don't tell anyone you have this condition. It is the most highly stigmatized. People do not understand it. People will think, and this comes from a mental health professional, like, you're crazy. People, like, don't tell any medical professionals. They'll think, like, you'll want to sue them or take them to court.
A national cosmetology franchise threw an ex parte restraining order at him.
What this dude is doing is regular for him. This is like, this is normal, which is very weird. He's done this more than a few times, and every single time he gets shut the fuck up with facts.
And now this. Baby, can't you see?
Unfortunate that he is the way he is, because I've heard from so many people who used to be subscribers of his, saying that they used to love his content, but he became so negative and so mean to people, and just he lashed out for no reason. And it's true. It's so sad to see people who have potential to be good in what they do turn it around and completely just fuck it up for themselves. It's sad.
And he's like, I believe that you have borderline personality disorder.
Borderline. Feels like I'm going to lose my mind.
I, the angry gay Pope, do not think Steven Mango is an asset to the Scientology whistleblower community. As I will show in my next episode, Steven Mango attempts to survive a chocolate factory tour. Patrons at patreon.com/angrygaypope will see it first.
We are the music makers, and we are the dreamers of dreams.